Hi, welcome to the Subtitle Edit tutorial series. In this episode, you'll learn the basics to quickly get started with Subtitle Edit in just a few minutes. Please note that Subtitle Edit, as known as SE, only officially supports Windows platforms so far, so this series will be made based on the Windows version. However, there are workarounds to use it on other operating systems like macOS or Linux. Also, there's other alternative subtitling software to use, such as AGSub. There will be tutorials for that as well. The reason we recommend using SE is that it is free to use, yet with many powerful features for all kinds of captioning workflows. Now, let's see how to create your first SRT file with SE. To download it, please go to github.com/subtitleedit/subtitleedit/releases, or you can just simply Google it. Then choose a version to download. Usually, a portable version would be just fine. To install it, after downloading the package, unzip it. If you downloaded the installer version, just double-click the executable file and follow the setup steps to finish it. After that, a new desktop icon is added for you to launch. If you download the portable version, find a file named subtitleedit.exe and double-click on it. Then you can launch SE directly. Or you may want to unzip the package to an appropriate directory and create a desktop icon for that file. Now, let's launch it to meet its interface. The default interface of SE includes title, menu, toolbar, list view, video player, text box, mode tabs, waveform, and info bar. Now, let's do some basic setup for GT jobs. First, we need to create a new profile for GT jobs. Go to Options, Settings, click the button next to the profile list, click New, rename the new profile, and then set values according to the official guidelines. After that, click OK. Select that profile from the list, click OK. Now, right-click on the top of the list view, toggle both Gap and Characters per second, aka CPS. Please note that this is a one-time setup for GT jobs, so normally you don't need to go through it every time. To get started, we need both the transcription and media file. After taking the subtitle job, you need to download either the source video file or only the audio file from the same video. Then, download the transcription text file accordingly. Normally, just download the no speakers text version. Open SE, go to File, Import, Plain Text. In the pop-up window, click the Open Text File button. Choose the text file you just downloaded and click Open. With the default setting, the transcription has been split into many subtitle rows or lines. However, the auto-split text is not the best option for our jobs in most cases. So here we choose one line is one subtitle and leave other settings as default, then click OK. Now the texts are imported to the list view. Now let's load a MIDI file. There are several ways to do so. You can either go to Video, Open Video File, or simply click on the Video Player. However, the recommended way is to click the waveform area so that SE can automatically generate the waveform from the media file right after loading it. Or you can just simply drag the video or audio file onto the waveform or video player area from the file path. Now we can finally start captioning. In Mode tabs, switch to Adjust tab. Now select the first row in the list view. Then hit spacebar to start or stop playing the media. The sine line here indicates the video position. Normally, it is recommended to enable the center button as well. When you hear the first speaker start talking, press the Set Start and Offset Rest button on the Adjust tab, or simply press F9 on your keyboard. As you can see, a block is then created in the waveform area, which represents a subtitle row or line in the list view with a duration of 2 seconds by default. Now you can drag it left and right to offset its position. You can also drag the left border to change the start time and drag the right border to change the end time. And single click anywhere on the waveform will change the current video position. After figuring out the appropriate end for the current line, press Set End and go to Next button, or press F10 on your keyboard. Now you can see the next row in the list view is then highlighted, which means you are now working on the next subtitle line. Then play the media and repeat the same steps we just mentioned. Sometimes lines need to be merged or split for better arrangement. To merge lines, right-click on a block from the context menu, choose Merge with Previous or Merge with Next. To split a line, first place the video cursor somewhere it should be. Then go to the text box, place the text cursor somewhere it should be, and select Split Line at Cursor Video Position. Also, there are two useful buttons near the text box, the Unbreak button and Auto Breaking button. They are quite intuitive. Just use them when you need to. When you're working on it, you may see some orange cells in the list view, meaning that there are errors that don't meet certain rules according to your setup. If the color cells are in the start time or end time column, it means there are overlap issues. If the color cells are in other columns, it means either the duration gap or text is too long or too short. To fix such issues, rather than fixing each of them manually, you may want to go to Tools, Fix Common Errors, or simply press Ctrl+Shift+F. First, you need to choose the error types. Click Next, then check everything in the next window. If everything is OK, just press Apply Selected Fixes, then press OK. However, some errors still need manual fixes. Remember, it is recommended to fix all issues when you finish adding time codes. Finally, go through the list view again. Make sure no cells are colored, then make sure to save the SRT file one more time. Now, you can upload your work to finish the job. That's it. Congratulations, you made it. For more advanced tips to hugely increase your captioning efficiency, feel free to check other episodes on how to become a real captioning expert. See you next time.